videotaping me right now.
But you look so pretty.
Is that pretty? I'll tell you, get me in that thing, I'm gonna break it.
I'm sorry?
You like my knit?
Well, like, what did you need to do?
It's just not painful to try to be pretty.
To try.
Yeah, I gotta try
to be pretty.
Be the answer.
Stop it.
At the end of the line, I'll be there for you. Why take the time in the burning of uncertainty? I will be your solid ground. I will hold the balance. Can't look down. If it takes my whole life, I won't break, I won't bend. It'll all be worth it, worth it in the end. 'Cause I can only tell you.
Jesse and Jennifer today as they celebrate and commemorate this very special day. It marks a new change. All of us are not here by accident. We're here because we have relationships with Jesse and with Jennifer. And it's because of that relationship we have with them that we're here to personally support.
That I can wash this pledge.
Setting in front of your family and friends. By our presence here, we acknowledge our support for you and for your love, the decisions you've made in marriage, live together as husband and wife. As Jennifer and Jesse will be making commitments to one another today, and I, as participants, even though we are the audience, we also are here to acknowledge Jesse, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health? Will you forsake all others and be faithful only to Jennifer as long as you both shall live? Jennifer, will you have this man, Jesse, to be your husband? Live together in holy marriage. Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health? Will you forsake all others and be faithful only to Jesse as long as you both shall live? I want to thank both of you for allowing me to be part of this special. You'll join hands today as you take these vows. You'll repeat after me. I love you, Jennifer. You are my best friend. I love you, Jennifer. You are my best friend. Today I give myself to you in marriage. I promise to encourage and inspire you. I promise to laugh with you. To comfort you in times of sorrow and struggle. I guess I must be here. Promise to love you. Good times and it's bad. When life seems easy and when it seems hard. Make it up. When our love is simple and when it is an effort, simple. I promise to cherish you, and to always hold you in the highest regard. These things I give to you today and for the rest of you. You'll repeat after me.
Got plenty of time.
Jennifer, if you'll repeat after me, I love you, Jesse. You are my best friend. Today I give myself to you in marriage.
God,
promise to encourage and inspire you. To laugh with you.
Standing here beside me. I love
to love you. Love
time.
In good times and in bad.
Never for money. Always for love.
Cover up when it isn't happy. Promise to cherish you and to always hold you in the highest regard. These things I give to you today, for you and for the rest of our
people.
Let's pray and ask God's blessing upon these readings today. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. You'll place that on Jennifer's finger and say, with this ring, I marry you and give to you my faithful love. With this ring, I marry you and give to you my faithful love. Under God, I want you to take your sand and I want you to pour it in the top of that glass clock. He's reaching for it.
I want to do it, Mom.
I want to
pour it. There we go. You know, just as this sand gets all mixed up in there, that's what God does in a time like this. It's very mysterious. But the Bible says the two shall become one. So your mom and dad have become one flesh, and you are one family, and as the sand mixes together, just like nothing can separate that sand back into the individual colors, nothing can separate you guys.
As an ordained minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and by the authority I have and the laws of the state of Washington, I now officially pronounce, you ready? You are a husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Kiss your wife. May I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jesse Fouché. Horns.
Joseph Plano.
Very nice.
Rob.
Rob.
Take Amy.
Come on, she's waiting for you.
It wouldn't be proper for us to eat the cake.
Say something nice to Farton Martin.
And then usually the preacher likes to bless the food first, too.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Woo!
Went home and melted in my couch.
What are you going to do?
Oh, you get to
go to Disneyland.
Yeah.